Hello everyone and welcome to the channel. So today I do want to speak about something that you guys have been wanting me to speak about. So today we will talk about the UCL predictions. And I was planning on making this video like about 3 weeks ago before the round of 16 started, but I really wanted to get a good feel on what are the squad's current conditions, how do they play. And so I wanted to watch the first leg first and then give my final predictions before the second leg. So we will start with the Barcelona versus Napoli game, and you guys know what I think about this game. I know for this game Barcelona will go through. Barcelona is a team that has a point to prove in the UCL, and that goal that was scored by Griezmann really gave us a huge advantage. And playing at home is going to be much easier for us to get a good result because we know that the field will be much wider and Barcelona knows what to do in those spaces. And I know that we will not have Vidal and Busquets, but hopefully we are going to get Sergio Roberto back and Jordi Alba. We have heard Quique Setién speak about that he wished that he could have used Ansu Fati more in this game against Napoli in the first leg. So I believe we will see that happen in the next game at the Camp Nou. So with those two players and Ansu Fati back in the starting 11, I believe that we will persevere and get a big win. So Barcelona will advance, beating Napoli 3-0 at the Camp Nou. Now moving on to Bayern Munich versus Chelsea. I thought that this was going to be more of an even game, but I believe that Bayern Munich will go through to the next round. Chelsea did experience a very devastating loss at their home, which ended 3-0, and now heading into Bayern's home, I just don't see Chelsea pulling off a win against Bayern Munich. I don't even see them going through. Even with Lewandowski not being available, actually he might not be available in this match because it has been reported that he will be missing around 4 weeks. But even without Lewandowski, Bayern Munich still has enough stars and they have enough quality to beat down Chelsea in Germany. And it's mainly because Chelsea lack defensive structure. They are doing well in the Premier League. Like right now, Chelsea's at fourth place, but they are statistically one of the worst teams to keep a clean sheet. And those stats will haunt them and they will show when they do go up against Bayern Munich at Germany. So Bayern Munich will beat Chelsea 2-0 in the second leg. Now I want to move on to PSG versus Dortmund, and this is probably one of the toughest games to predict because I don't know who could win and who could come out with a victory, but I think that in the end Dortmund will go through. Dortmund has been one of the best improved teams in the UCL, and we did face them in the group stages. Like us, Barcelona, we did face Dortmund in the group stages, but this Dortmund that we are currently seeing in the UCL is a completely different Dortmund. They are a completely different animal, and that's mainly because of one reason and one player. That is Erling Haaland. Haaland at the moment is considered one of the greatest strikers in world football, and he did carry Dortmund to a win against PSG. And I believe that he's going to do the exact same thing in the second leg, regardless if it's going to be in Germany or in France. Haaland will show up. And since we know that this will be in Paris, Neymar and Mbappe will need to show up, and I believe they will. They will do some damage, but I don't think it's going to be enough. And I just don't see PSG outscoring Dortmund. This will be a game on who scores the most, and whoever scores the most will go on to the next round. But with Haaland, Sancho, Hazard building chemistry and doing well in Borussia Dortmund, I believe Dortmund will go through and beating PSG in France 3-1. Now moving on to Atalanta versus Valencia. And this game had one of the most surprising losses. Valencia did lose 4-1 in the first leg, and I believe that Atalanta will go through. The next game will be in Spain, but if we look at the scoreline again, it ended 4-1 and Valencia really gave themselves a hard time to go to the next round. Because if Valencia wants to progress to the next round, they will need to score 3 goals against Atalanta, and not just that, but also keep a clean sheet. If Atalanta scores 1 goal, it'll be over for Valencia. So it is that easy for Valencia to be knocked out. And Atalanta will be going into this game knowing that already they have a foot in the quarterfinals. And so that itself is going going to bring a lot of confidence to Atalanta, and I can see Atalanta simply just defending their lead. So my predicted scoreline for this match is Valencia wins 1-0, but it will not be enough to progress to the next round. So Atalanta goes through. Now moving on to Leipzig versus Tottenham. So Leipzig is one of the underdogs in the UCL. No one expected them to come this far, and at the moment Tottenham is at a huge disadvantage. Not because of the one goal lead from Leipzig, but it is because Tottenham is missing two huge fundamental players, and that is Harry Kane and Son. They were hugely missed in the first leg because they were the players who simply created all the chances for Tottenham, and they are injured. They will be out for a good minute, meaning that they will be out for a couple of weeks. And I just don't see Tottenham coming out this round without Kane and Son. And looking at Timo Werner form this season, and I believe Leipzig will progress to the next round, beating Tottenham 1-0. Now I want to move on to Liverpool versus Atletico Madrid. And again, this is another game which was very hard to predict, because in the last game, Atletico Madrid defended extremely well. And for the first time ever, we get to see Liverpool's attack to be completely shut down. So this could go either way. Liverpool does look like they want to defend the title, and we know that Atletico Madrid is going to go into Anfield defending the full 90 minutes. And we know just how difficult it is to get through the Atletico Madrid defense. But again, it is so tough to see Liverpool exit this early in this stage. So here is what I think is going to happen. I believe Atletico Madrid will defend the full 90 minutes, but I just don't see Liverpool going scoreless again at Anfield. So Liverpool will go through, winning Atletico Madrid 2-0. Now moving on to Juve versus Lyon. And I'm going to say that Juventus will go through. As bad as Juve played against Lyon, I don't see Lyon holding off that lead when they head to Juventus. And yes, I know Juve did not have not one shot in the first leg, because Lyon was defending extremely well in this game. And one of Juve's biggest problems this season was getting the best out of Ronaldo. He has showed up in occasions, but it hasn't been consistent. And if you don't get your one and only star man to function well in the team, your shots, your chances, your build-up plays will greatly decrease. And it showed in this game against Lyon. So for Juventus to advance to the next round, it's going to greatly depend on one man, and that's going to be Cristiano Ronaldo. And knowing Ronaldo, I believe that he will show up in this big occasion. He will show up when Juventus really needs him. That is what makes him great, and I know that he will make that happen. My bet is on him to take Juventus to the next round. So Lyon is winning Juventus 1-0 at the moment, but Juventus will advance to the next round, beating Lyon in Italy 2-0. Now, lastly, I want to talk about Manchester City versus Real Madrid. Manchester City did beat Real Madrid 2-1 at the Santiago Bernabeu. And for the full 65 minutes of this game, it looked like Madrid was going to win in this match. They looked like clear favorites. And it was frustrating me because Manchester City had like two big chances and they blew it. And I felt like Man City was not going to go through, because I was like, look, Manchester City has a better attack than Real Madrid. And Real Madrid has better defense than Manchester City. And Manchester City was just not putting away those goals. And so that is why I was getting very frustrated. But then the last 15 minutes came and Manchester City scored two goals. Kevin De Bruyne did come off this game with one goal and one assist. And so he is just one hell of a player. I highly admire Kevin De Bruyne. He has tremendous quality. So with the damage that Manchester City brought to Real Madrid, that means that in the second leg, Real Madrid will need to beat Manchester City 2-0 in England in order to advance to the next round. But when Manchester City finds a rhythm and starts connecting, they really know how to connect. Then we start seeing a lethal, dangerous Manchester City, and that is what we got in those last 15 minutes. And I believe that is what we are going to get in the next round, in the second leg, when Manchester City plays at their home. So I am going to root for Manchester City. That is my second favorite team. I did watch them play also, and the reason why I'm rooting for them more than ever is because we don't know if this will be their last chance playing in the UCL until 2022-2023 season. We don't know if the band will be official for two seasons, and Man City is using this to their benefit, to their advantage, as motivation. And now knowing the current status of Real Madrid, Ramos will not participate in the next game because he did get booked with a red card. And so all of this gives Manchester City a greater chance of advancing to the next round. So I believe that Man City will advance and they will go to the quarterfinals, beating Real Madrid in England 3-1. So that is it for my UCL predictions. That is what I believe is going to happen in the second leg. Those are the teams that I believe is going to move to the quarterfinals. And I lastly want to end with a report that came out from Jared Romero, who is involved with RAC 1. It has been reported that Quique Setién and his assistant, they watched City's win over Madrid at the Santiago Bernabeu. They were in the stands. And so the question was, what was Quique Setién doing in those stands? Why was he there watching the game between Manchester City and Real Madrid? And I believe it's because of two reasons. One is because he went to go analyze Real Madrid for the Classico that's coming this weekend. Like, what are their strengths? What are their weaknesses? How can we place Real Madrid in the most vulnerable positions? And I give credit to Quique Setién because this man really means business. He is preparing early for this match. And this is something that Guardiola used to do at one point with FC Barcelona. And we know that Quique Setién already has experience playing against Real Madrid. He did beat Real Madrid with Real Betis. And so now that Quique Setién has these group of players like Messi, Vidal, Griezmann, and all these world-class players, and him preparing very well before the match, we can expect very good results coming this Sunday. And so the second reason why I believe that he was there is, could Quique Setién also be scouting some of Manchester City players? And this is me just like theorizing. I don't know if this is true, but we never know if this could be part of Quique Setién's agenda, because we know Manchester City's state at the moment. They might not be able to participate in the UCL for the next two seasons. So Man City do have players who are in their prime of their careers and will want to continue playing UCL football, which could very well alert Quique Setién. And there are players out there who might potentially look for an exit. So Setién could say, there are players out there who might potentially look for an exit. There are players out there who do match our team's profile. Why don't we just take a look at what Manchester City potentially has to offer to strengthen our squad for next season? So that could happen. That could be in Quique Setién's mind. We never know. Again, that is just me theorizing. So that is it for today's video. Those are my predictions, and that is what Quique Setién is currently doing with his schedule. It's very interesting to see how Setién is working and what he is doing to improve FC Barcelona. So yeah, again, that is it for today's video. I want to thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.